on our broadcast tonight, On the Brink. Israelis running for cover as bomb shelters open and Israel calls up 40,000 reserves.
The city of Jerusalem came under rocket attack. It happened literally seconds ago.
I'm a lieutenant and I'm a deputy commander in an Iron Dome battery.
I'm a major and engineer in core unit. I command a special operation to find and blow up terrorist tunnels.
I am reserve paramedic in the special unit of the Nahal Brigade.
As a commander in the IDF, for me it's a privilege to protect my home, to protect my land, to protect the whole Jewish nation.
During Operation Protective Edge, I was the commander of the rescue company responsible to evacuate the wounded and the casualties during the war.
I'm 20 years old. My base is here near the Gaza Strip.
A short time ago, Israeli officials reported an attempt by militants to invade southern Israel by sea.
At the first day of Protective Edge, two scuba divers, the commander of the Hamas, came through the water and started to run towards our base. When something like that happened, you don't have time to think. Me and another officer ran to the fighting zone and we started exchange of fire. Actually, we killed them.
In the last 24 hours, we've had 130 rockets that have targeted our civilians.
Every time people ask me about Iron Dome, I like to emphasize that behind this system, there is a man or a woman making sure the job is done. You have to react on time. You have to make the right decision. It's a matter of a few seconds. When you see a target on the screen, you can also see where it's potentially going to fall. So you know that each rocket that you're intercepting could hit a house, a family, children.
What is fear? How do you deal with fear?
In this extreme situation, I want to believe that I made the right decision.
So I heard someone in back of me yelling, "Where's Hadar? Where's Hadar? Hadar is missing." And that's when I understood Hadar was kidnapped.
The moment I heard that my brother is the missing soldier, I right away wanted to go back and help. It's my brother we're dealing with.
When we entered the tunnel, it was very dark. We barely saw anything, except for a trail of blood, so I knew exactly where I need to go. I told Lieutenant Shaked, "Wait here for 5 minutes. If I don't come back, I'm probably dead."
This is the longest 5 minutes of my life. I didn't ever watch.
I heard Shaked yelling to me, "We have to get out of the tunnel, we have to get out." Hadar was dead.
And when I first understood that he is gone, I felt something is now is missing.
These tunnels were extremely dangerous and we have to stop it.
And the Hamas terrorists blow a huge ID under the specific place that Ori stand inside the tunnel.
Place became like hell. All the injured just screamed. My EMT, he got in shock. He couldn't move or speak. So I grabbed him and I told him, "Just understand, we might lose one, but we will save five."
My family is very worried. Especially because I was injured twice, and the second time was very hard for me.
In midnight, his father called me and said that we need to go to the hospital.
"Hi, it's me. Come to the hospital again."
When you see officers like Ori coming back, this is courage.
Courage comes from the inside. comes from your soldiers, comes from the mission. You don't need to look a lot to find courage. It's just there.